In this video, we're going to see how to find the distance from a point to a line in 3 dimensions. The problem we're looking at says find the distance between the point 0, 3, 6 and the line x equals 1 minus t, y equals 1 plus 2t, z equals 5 plus 3t. So in step one, we will use the line equation to find a point on the line. So where we have the parametric equations of the line, so t is the parameter, and t can essentially be any real number to trace out the full line. So you can pick any value for t you want. And if you let t be zero, then those variable terms go away, and you just have the point with those constant values. And so we'll do that. And so our point will be 1, 1, 5. In the same step, we want to find a vector parallel to the line. And for that, we do use the coefficients of those variable terms. So you look at these variable terms, and the coefficients there form a vector parallel to the line. I mean, you can see the notation here, x naught, y naught, z naught, and v1, v2, v3, matching up with the equations of the line. And if you're given the symmetric version, you can still find those 6 numbers. So for us, the vector has -1 because it's negative t, 2 from 2t, and 3 from 3t. So you can always get the point and a vector parallel from the equation or equations of the line. Moving to step two, we want to determine a vector connecting the point to the line. So m is a point not on the line, and then p is the point on the line. So the vector from p to m connects the point on the line to the point off the line. So pm. And what we'd use here is the 0, 3, 6. That will be our m. That's the x1, y1, z1, right? And then this is x0, y0, z0. And then we just subtract those. So we'd have 0 minus 1, 3 minus 1, and 6 minus 5. And that will give us the vector negative 1, 2, 1. In step three, we find the cross product of the vectors from steps 1 and 2. PM from step two crossed with V from step one. And so we saw in the last methodology how to do that. We set up a matrix, and it's I, J, K in the first row, and then the first vector. So the middle row is the first vector mentioned in the cross product. So the vector from P to M, so -1, 2, 1, right there. And then the bottom row is the second vector mentioned in the cross product, which is v, which is -1, 2, 3. And then we just want to find that cross product. And looks like we are out of room, so let's move this a little bit. So this is still a little new for some folks, so we'll kind of rehash quickly how to do this, that we look at the vector I times its 2 by 2 minor. So 2, 1, 2, 3 times I, and then minus, and then we do that for J. So the 2 by 2 minor there, -1, 1, -1, 3. And then for K, it'd be -1, 2, -1, 2. And then we do the 2 by 2 determinants, multiplying from the top left to the bottom right, and multiplying from the top right to the bottom left, and subtracting those. So it'd be 2 times 3, which is 6, minus 2 times 1, which is 2. With the middle one, -1 times 3 is -3, minus -1 times 1 is -1. And with the last one, it's -1 times 2 minus -1 times 2. So we get 4i. This is -3 plus 1, which is -2, but then there's a negative there, so 2j. And then 0k, so 4, 2, 0. So that's the cross product of the two vectors, 4, 2, 0. All right, so to get the distance, we put all this together in this formula. So the We have the vector PM cross V, which is 4, 2, 0. We want the magnitude of that, which is the square root of the sum of the squares. So 4 squared plus 2 squared plus 0 squared, which is square root of 20. And then the denominator is the magnitude of V. V was given to us. No, V was figured out in step one. It's from the equation of the line, and it's -1, 2, 3. And its magnitude is square root of 14. So that's the exact distance, square root of 20 over square root of 14, which you could write as square root of 10 over 7. If you need to approximate it, you should get about 1.195. For validation here, you can find the distance from an arbitrary point, x1, y1, z1, to any point in the line as a function of t. And then use calc 1 to find the minimum value of that function. So using the distance formula in 3 dimensions, we again use our point M, 0, 3, 6, and then we use the point on the line, we would use those equations, right? So x was 1 minus t, right? That used the equations from the very beginning for the line. Y was 1 plus 2t, and z was 5 plus 3t. So that was all given to us. So we use that for the other point. So this will be x2, y2, z2. And then we just do the normal distance formula. So x2 minus x1 squared, y2 minus y1 squared, and z2 minus z1 squared. So this ends up being a function of t. And if you simplify it, You got this. And so finding the minimum value, you can use calculus and do this completely analytically. For that, it'd probably be easier to just work with d squared, and not have the square root, and then take the derivative, set it equal to zero, and solve. But this isn't a Calc 1 class, and so the easy way to do this is just to graph the function. And we can. Use GeoGebra for that. We could use Desmos since it's just a basic 2D graph. So there's the function, and then you want to find the minimum value. And of course, most of these graphing tools will just snap right on to that minimum value. Now we're looking for the minimum value of the function, which is the y coordinate. And you get, of course, a decimal approximation. So you'd want to put in that square root of 10 over 7. We saw it was about 1.195, but maybe compare further digits to make sure it really is accurate. And it is. You can check that. So just comparing that y coordinate there with the answer to step four. All right, that'll do it for finding the distance from a point to a line. Remember, there's a second methodology for this section, and so I'll see you there.